The United Nations General Assembly, the annual meeting of the leaders of the UN's 193 member states, begins tomorrow in New York. On Tuesday, President Trump will deliver his first speech at the UN, and in the past, he's accused it of weakness and incompetence and threatened to cut U.S. funding. To discuss what to expect, I'm joined by Washington Post White House correspondent David Nakamura. So, President Trump, this is his debut at the UN, and as we mentioned, he's never been a huge fan. Can you talk to us a little bit about what his administration is doing to kind of prepare and approach this meeting and what we think he might say on Tuesday?
Sure, Megan. You know, I was at the White House the other day when his top advisors, including UN Ambassador Nikki Haley and H.R. McMaster, the National Security Advisor, gave sort of a briefing. And President Trump, as you said, has not really been a fan of some of these international institutions such as NATO and the UN, and said they've not lived up to their billing and that they're costing the U.S. too much in resources and relying too much on the United States to lead the way. But what's interesting is that both of his aides said they really expect the United States and the administration to show a leadership role here on things ranging from North Korea's nuclear threat, the Iran nuclear deal, terrorism, and even human rights, which President Trump has not talked about a lot. But I think what's interesting is if you look back to last year, President Obama in his final address really said that the world was at a sort of a point where it had to make a choice between sort of continuing in sort of the multilateral engagement that marked the post-World War II era, or retreating, President Obama said, to tribalism and building walls. And of course, you had a president and President Trump who campaigned on building a wall. And we don't know whether he'll actually get that done. But the question is sort of the tone. Will Trump sort of paint a dark picture of the world in the way he's talked about it in the past? Or will he sort of reach out and sort of talk about the merits of this kind of world body? Nikki Haley said, as the president, she's seen the speech. We haven't seen it. But she said the president slaps the right people and he hugs the right people. And in the end, the U.S. comes out stronger.
Okay, let's talk about some of these specific issues. So North Korea, obviously a big one. North Korea keeps testing missiles and nuclear weapons despite tougher UN sanctions. How do we think that might play out?
That's really interesting. Nikki Haley has really talked about the process at the UN. She's sort of dismissive, said they used to be all worried about, you know, dotting the I's and crossing the T's on and commas and periods on resolutions that were somewhat toothless. But these votes to enact broad sanctions on oil exports from to North Korea and cuts on North Korea exports is really going to pinch Pyongyang. But no one expects that to necessarily change the calculus for Kim Jong-un. And I think President Trump himself has said he doesn't necessarily know how much these sanctions will do. So I think what you're likely to hear from the president is continued tough talk. You know, he's talked about military options being on the table. And Nikki Haley said that as well. And I think the question is, what would that mean? And what also would it take for there to be some direct engagement with the regime in the north?
What else? What else should we be looking for this week?
On Iran, the president's meeting on Monday with Benjamin Netanyahu of Israel, who was certainly very vocal against this Iran nuclear deal. The administration has sent signals that they don't think that the Iranian regime is complying with the spirit of that deal, and suggested maybe that they would seek to maybe potentially enact more sanctions on Iran, which could unravel that deal. There's a deadline in about a month for the administration to make the call whether Iran is complying. There's a lot at stake here for the president.
David Nakamura of The Washington Post, thank you so much for joining us.
Sure, thanks. Anytime.